Okay, so the time period can be equal to 2 pi times square root m over k. So therefore, the time period t here should have a dimensional formula, which is m over k to the power of 1/2. So we know mass has unit kilogram, and kilogram, spring constant has unit newton per meter. And we know newton can be equal to kilogram times meter per second square, okay? Because force is equal to ma. So therefore, we have spring constant's unit is just simply equal to kilogram per second square. And if we convert it back to the dimension formula, we have K is equal to let's say capital M over T squared. Okay? Because M stands for the mass, and mass has a unit kilogram, and T is the time period, and time period has a unit second. So therefore, time period squared is equal to second squared. And then, therefore, the mass here should be equal to capital M. So therefore, we have time period is equal to M over K to the power of 1/2, which is equal to M over M per T squared to the power of 1/2. And this will give us M times T squared over M to the power of 1/2. And then M can be canceled out. So therefore, we have T is equal to T squared to the power of 1/2, which is equal to T. Okay. And therefore, the expressions for the periods are reasonable. Okay. And these are my answers for this question.